Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you all know that we have started chapter 4, the enemy. It is the enemy actually, not enemy. Let me write down it correctly. Investors. Okay. So yesterday first video on this lesson was recorded, was uploaded, in which we discussed about the author and I read out a few paragraphs and explained. Today first of all we will go through a short summary of what we discussed in my last video. Then I'll read out some more paragraphs and explain. So as of now in this lesson we have seen that this lesson is about a doctor, a surgeon whose name is Sadao. Sadao, when he was a child, since then, his father was very strict. He never made any joke with him. He never played with him. He only wanted to make him a surgeon. When Sadao grew up, he not only became a surgeon, but also a famous scientist. So now, in the first paragraph, the writer tells us about the place where his home was situated. It was at the coast of sea. Further, the author tells us about the weather of that time. The author also tells us about his wife, Hana. He met Hana when he went abroad, when he went to America for higher study. As his father was very much, you know, concerned about his career, so when Dr. Sadao was fully confirmed that Hana was pure Japanese, as his father was also against, to get married in any other caste. So that is why in any other caste or religion or any other country. So that is why when it was ensured by Dr. Sadao that Hana was pure Japanese, then he fell in love. So he did not get married in America. When they came back to Japan, so then they got married. So we saw that Sadao's father was very much concerned about Sadao's education. Sadao's education was his main concern, so he wanted him to be a surgeon. So he not only became a surgeon but also became a famous scientist. Dr. Sadao's house built on the Japanese coast. So in the first paragraph the writer tells us about Dr. Sadao's home, which was there on the Japanese coast. Sadao knew that his education was his father's chief concern. Sadao was very well aware that his education was the chief concern of his father. For this, he had sent him to America to learn surgery and medicine. So as his father wanted him to become a surgeon, so that is why he was sent to America and to learn surgery and medicine. Before his father died, he had seen Sadao become a famous surgeon and scientist. So before Sadao's father had died, Sadao was able to fulfill his wish and he became a famous surgeon as well as scientist as his father wanted to make him. Later, how Sadao married Hana, later we have read in the lesson. Sadao had met Hana in America at a professor's house. So most probably Hana and Sadao, they would be going to, they might be going to a professor's home in order to learn English as they were Japanese. As it has not been mentioned, but we can imagine. Sadao had met Hana in America at a professor's house. He did not fall in love with her until he was sure that she was Japanese. His father would have never accepted her unless she had been pure in race. So as his father was against it, so he would have never been accepted her if she was not of pure Japanese race. So they came home in Japan. Their marriage had been arranged in the old Japanese tradition. So this is what we have read as of now. So let us go through so a few more paragraphs. I will read out and explain. It was at this moment that both of them saw something black come out of the mist. So when they were standing in their balcony, suddenly Dr. Sadao as well as Hana saw something black which was coming out of the mists, coming out of the fog. It was a man. He was flung up out of the ocean. So it was a man came out of the sea. Flung, it seemed, to his feet by a breaker. So it seemed that he fell off by striking to a breaker. He staggered a few steps, his body outlined against the mist. So he he could not walk properly. With the heavy effort he moved a few steps and his body outlined against the mist, so his body could be seen, his arms above his head. Then the curled mists hid him again. So as it was foggy weather, it was mist. So the man which came out from the sea, which had been thrown out of the sea, so the man once again he hid himself in the mist. "Who is that?" Hana cried. So Hana cried, "Who could be the person?" She dropped Sadao's arm and they both leaned over the railing of the veranda. They both leaned over the railing of the veranda and they started looking in the, towards the man. Now they saw him again. The man was on his hands and knees crawling. Then they saw him fall on his face and lying there. Okay. So then they saw him fall on his face and lie there. Further, they both saw his face and he was lying there at the coast. The man was lying. A fisherman, perhaps, Sadao said, washed from his boat. So Sadao thought it would be fisherman who might have been thrown away from his boat. He might have been washed from his boat. He ran quickly down the steps, and behind him Hana came, her white sleeves flying. So he ran quickly down the steps, and behind him Hana also came, her white sleeves flying. Hana's white sleeves were flying. A mile or two away on either side, there were fishing villages, but here was only the bare and lonely coast, dangerous with rocks. So a mile or two away on either side, there was a fishing villages where fishermen used to live, but there was only the bare and lonely coast, dangerous with rocks. The surf beyond the beach was spiked with rocks. So the surf, the waves, beyond the beach, it was full of, rocks, prinky rocks, sharp end rocks. Somehow the man had managed to come through them. He must be badly torn. So somehow the man had managed to come out of those rocks, and the man was badly torn. They saw, when they came to word him, that indeed it was so. So when they came to word him, then it seemed that the man did struggle, then he came out of it. The sand was one side of him had already a stain of red soaking through. So the sand one side of him had already, a stain with blood. Red soaking through means, there was the signs of blood, as blood soaking through the sands. So he is wounded, Sadao explained. Sadao explained that the man was wounded, man was injured. He made haste to the man. Sadao went to the man, who lay motionless, his face in the sand. So the man was laying there motionless, his face was in the sand. An old cap stuck to his head, soaked with sea water. An old cap stuck to his head, soaked with sea water. So he was wearing a cap because he was in the sea. So that is why the cap was soaked with sea water. He was in wet rags of garment. So as he was thrown out of the sea, that is why he was in wet garments. Sadao stopped Hana at his side and turned the man's head. Sadao stopped Hana at his side and turned the man's face, the man who was laying there injured. They saw the face. A white man, Hana whispered. Hana said, when she saw the face of the injured man, she cried, "A white man." She whispered. "Yes, it was a white man." The wet cap fell away, and there was his wet yellow hair, long as though for many weeks it had not been cut. So when the cap fell away, there was wet yellow hair, and it seemed that the hair was not cut. It had not been cut, since many weeks. And upon his young and tortured face was a rough yellow beard,
So upon his young and tortured face was a rough yellow beard. He was unconscious and knew nothing that they did for him. So the man was unconscious and he did not know how he reached in this condition and who he knew that who were behind it, but he did not know how he reached in this condition, how he was in the sea, and finally how he was on the coast. Now Sadao remembered the wound, and with his expert fingers he began to search for it. So Sadao, as you know, the signs of blood were there, so he knew that the man was injured, so he started looking for the wound. He began to search for wound. Blood flowed freshly at his touch. So when he touched, so blood flowed freshly. On the right side of the lower back, Sadao saw that a gun wound had been reopened. So on the right side of his lower back, Sadao saw that a gun wound means he was shot with the bullet. The flesh was blackened with powder. So because of the powder of the bullet, the wound, the flesh was blackened. Sometimes, not many days ago, the man had been shot and had not been tended. So after going through his wound, Sadao examined that some days ago he had been shot but had not been cured. Tended means cured. It was bad chance that the rock had stuck the wound. So wound became more severe because of the because the man struck to the rocks. So because of that, his wound became more severe. "Oh, how he is bleeding," Hana whispered again in a solemn voice, in a serious and concerned voice. Solemn means serious and concerned. Hana said, "How he is bleeding." The mists screened them now completely, and at this time of day no one came by. The mists screened them now completely. So now it was getting dark, so it covered them completely. So it became dark, and at this time of the day no one came by, no one visited there. The fishermen had gone home, and even the chance beachcombers would have considered the day at an end. Even the beachcombers mean vagrant who comes a living by searching beaches for articles of value and selling them. Okay, so the beachcombers also would have considered the day at an end, and they also left. So writer wants to tell us that it was the time of the day when no one would visit there. "What shall we do with this man?" So further he thought that, "What shall be done with the man?" Sadao muttered. Sadao also whispered. But his trained hands seemed of their own will to doing what they could to stanch the fearful bleeding. but his expert hand wanted to do stop the, you know, blood flowing. Stanch means, you know, a stop or restrict a flow of blood from a wound. But his expert and trained hand seemed of their own will to be doing what they could do to stop the fearful bleeding. So as he was expert in curing such types of wound, he had mastery over it, so he could not, you know, stop his hand doing so. He packed the wound with sea moss. He took sea moss and packed the wind that strewed the beach, that, you know, to be scattered and tightly over the place or area. So it was scattering there, the moss was scattering there. He took it. The man moaned with pain in his stupor, but he did not walk in. So because of pain, the man gave a low cry in pain and in his state of unconsciousness, but he did not awaken. Stupor means state of unconsciousness, and moaned means a low cry within pain. Okay. The best thing that we could do would be to put him back in the sea, Siddhao said, answering himself. So Siddhao, first of all, Siddhao thought that they should throw him back into the he should be thrown back to the sea. So first of all, Siddhao thought that he should throw the man into the sea again. Now that the bleeding was stopped for the moment, he stood up and dusted the stand from his hands. So now, till now, the bleeding was stopped. For the moment, he stood up and dusted the sand from his hand. Siddhao stood up and dusted the sands from his hand. Yes, undoubtedly, that would be the best, Hana said steadily. Hana also agreed. He said that yes, it would be the best way. It would be the best when the man would be thrown back into the sea. So why did they decide to throw the man back into the sea? Because those days a war between Japan and America was going on, and Japanese and Americans were enemies of each other. So that is why he decided to throw him back to the sea, because he was he belonged to the enemy soldier. He belonged to the enemy country. So that is why Siddhao as well as Hana thought of throwing him back into the sea. But she continued to stare down at the motionless man. So Hana also said so, but she continues staring down to that motionless man. If we sheltered a white man in our house, we should be arrested, and if we turned him over as a prisoner, he would be certainly die, Siddhao said. So Siddhao said, if we sheltered a white man in our house, then we should be arrested. So if they would shelter, so then they would be arrested, as it was thought by Siddhao. And if we turned him over as a prisoner, so he would be certainly die, Siddhao said. So as dear students here, Siddhao as a doctor, so he was thinking about a patient. So when he was thinking about a patient, so he did not want to throw him back into the sea, as he was a surgeon and it was his duty to save a person's life. Okay, so when he was thinking of saving a person's life, then he was in dilemma. when he was thinking him as an enemy, as he belonged to America, to enemy country. So he thought that he should throw back into the sea, throw him back into the sea. But when he thought that, he was a patient, and then he thought that he should be cured. So it was a dilemma. It was very difficult for Sadao to take this decision. The kindest thing would be to put him back into the sea, Hana said. Hana said the kindest thing would be to throw the man back into the sea. But neither of them moved. They were, saying so, but neither of them moved. They were straining with a curious repulsion upon the inert figure. So they were staring with a curious repulsion. Repulsion means, a great hatred, a strong dislike. So they were looking at the man, they were staring at the man with a strong dislike, but neither of them moved. And here inert means, the motionless person. So they both were looking at the motionless figure, the motionless man, with extreme hatred, with a strong dislike. What is he? Hana whispered. There is something about him that looks American, Sadao said. Sadao said he, looks American. He took up the battered cap. He took up his battered cap. The man's battered means, torn and worn out. Okay. Yes, they're almost gone was a faint lettering. So he was fully unconscious. The man was faint and he was, in a messy way, he was laying there. A sailor, he said, from an American warship. He spelled it out. U.S. Navy. The man was a prisoner of war. So here they came to know that that man was a prisoner of war, and he belonged to U.S. Navy. So what we have discussed as of now, dear students, in this lesson, we have seen that suddenly Hana and Sadao found a wounded American soldier, whose name was Tom. And Tom was found on the beach growling. Sadao and Hana found something coming out of the mist. So something was crawling, something was coming out of the mist. It was seen by Hana and Sadao from their balcony. A man seemed to be on his hands and knees crawling. So they saw a man was on his hands and knees. The man was crawling. Then they saw him fall on his face and lie there. So further, they saw the man. They saw him fall his face and lie there. So the man was lying. The man was lying motionless there. Further, they saw, as we have read. So he was wounded and lay motionless on the sand. A gun wound had reopened on the right side of his lower back and was bleeding. So when Sadao found that he was injured by he was shot by the gun and the wound had opened. So that is why it was bleeding, the blood was coming. Sadao packed the wound with sea moss Sedao took some sea moss and packed the wound. He cried but didn't wake up. So the man was crying in pain, but he did not wake up. When Sedao put some moss on his wound, then he cried but he did not wake up. They read the faint letters on his cap. There was faint letters on his cap, and it was written US Navy. So the American was a prisoner of war. So they, at that point, when they read about these words, these fainted words, when they read that fainted words, then they came to know that the man belonged to the US Navy. The American was a prisoner of war, and they came to know that man was a prisoner of war, an enemy of the Japanese. So as the war during those days, the war was going on between America and Japan. So they found that the man was an enemy of Japan. So that is why surgeon Dr. Sedao was in dilemma whether he should take the man to his home and give him shelter and cure him. If he would consider him as a patient, then he should do his duty as a doctor. But when he would consider himself as a patriot, then he should throw him back into the sea, as he was an enemy of Japanese. He was American, he was of US Navy. Okay, so it's all about this video, dear students. In my next video, I'll read out and explain a few more paragraphs. So please keep watching all the videos, keep attending online classes, and keep completing your notebook and keep mailing them. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.